quite some time ago, I made a video comparing the extrude, offset face, and emboss commands. In this video, I'm going to attempt to combine the effects of the extrude and emboss commands. Let's do a quick overview of the extrude and emboss commands. I'm going to perform an extrude with this sketch using the cylindrical face as the starting face. This produces a straight projection. If we look at this from the front, we can see that the sketch lines up exactly with the extrusion. This sort of straight projection tends to have a warping effect on shapes at the extreme ends. The circular ends of the slot tends to look elliptical. The extrusion is perpendicular to the sketch plane, which we can tell by the straight side walls. These two faces have the same curvature. With the same sketch and the same cylinder, let's perform an emboss. The emboss command is able to wrap the sketch onto the cylinder. We can verify this with a simple measurement. We can see the length of this sketch segment by simply clicking on it. To measure this length, we need to go to Inspect, Measure. So the emboss command performs a true wrap. Because of this, the ends of the slot tend to look more natural. The emboss command produces side walls that are perpendicular to the cylindrical face. These two faces are concentric. Here is a summary of the two commands. So here comes the question. How do we combine these selected properties from both these commands? In other words, how do we produce a straight extrusion that wraps around the cylinder? Let's take a look at the following method. We would actually start by using the sketch to perform an emboss. The purpose of creating this emboss is so that we can have access to these edges, which represents how the sketch wraps onto the cylinder. Activate the Surface tab. Select all these unwanted faces. And press the Delete key. Now, we are going to build the side walls. Go to Create, Root. Check the Chain Selection option and select these chain of edges. Set Type to Direction. Check on the select box. And select the front plane. This will extrude the surface in a direction perpendicular to the front plane. Adjust the distance. We want to adjust this more than required. I have prepared a sketch here. This is a center point arc with the same curvature as a cylinder, but advanced forward by 5 mm. Go to Create, Extrude. Extrude this sketch down so that it completely cuts through the root face. Go to Modify, Trim. Select this face as the trim tool. Select this portion of the root face to remove. Repeat the trim tool. Select the root face as the trim tool. And select this portion to be removed. Now we have a watertight surface body. Go to Create, Boundary Fill. Select all these surface bodies. Click on the Select box for selecting cells. Select this cell. Hope this has been helpful. I will see you in the next one.